And now I am going to describe some of the basic commands which are regularly used in Unix along with demonstration. For demonstration I am going to use FreeBSD. I am using a software called PuTTY to connect with the FreeBSD Unix. So whatever I am doing in PuTTY, those things are going to be reflected on my FreeBSD Unix system. So the first command is echo. So this command is used to display messages on the screen. So let's see this thing in action. So the command is echo, and whatever you want to display on the screen, you have to type it, like hello world. So that is the output. It simply prints it back, whatever message we give, echo. We can give in double quotes also, like a string, welcome to Unix, I am enjoying this, something like that. So this is a simple command. Whatever we give on the shell, as an argument to the command echo, that thing will be printed back on the screen. So here this echo is a command, and welcome to Unix, I am enjoying this, is called an argument. Let's come back. So next command is tput. This command controls the cursor movement on the screen along with another argument called cup. So let's see this thing in action. This thing won't work on PuTTY, but I will use Xubuntu for this. So the command is tput and argument is cup. Along with this, we have to give two more arguments, like the row and the column to which we have to move the cursor. For example, I am giving the column 30. So the shell has shifted, the cursor has shifted from here to here. That's the thing. And you can find out the number of lines or rows on your screen by giving tput rows. It is not rows, I think it is lines. Yes. So on this screen there are 22 rows or lines, 1, 2, 3, so on. And if you want to find out the vertical columns, the thing you can use is tput cols. There are 71 columns. So let's come back. And next command is tty. So previously I told you that there is a single Unix server which can be accessed by multiple clients, and each client will have something called a device file, and you can view this device file by using the command tty. So let me find out what my device file name is. So tty. So this is my device file name, dev pts0. So all the device files will be stored in one directory called dev. Let's come back. And next command is who. This command is viewed. This command can be used to view the number of users connected to the Unix system. So for example, if we type who, we can see there are currently two sessions to the Unix server, which is my FreeBSD Unix here. So here you can see the username, here you can see the terminal or device that user is using, and also you can see the date and time at which the user logged into the system, and also the IP from which they are accessing the system. So here there are only one user, so you can see only two rows. But in a real-time scenario, if you sit at a Unix system and type this command, you will be seeing a lot of rows here with different usernames and different IPs, so that you can know which user is using from where. Let's come back. Next command is uname. This command is used to view information regarding your Unix OS. So So let's see this uname command in action. So if I give uname without any arguments, it will show me the OS vendor name. It is I don't mean vendor, it is like the which version of Unix we are using. So the thing I am using is FreeBSD. But if you give uname along with an option, so here hyphen A is called an option, you can see a lot of information about your Unix OS. So it is showing excuse me, it is showing the version name as 11.1 and release number as 0R321309, and you can also see some more details, and at the end it is showing that this is i386. So this is a 32 bit operating system. Let's come back, and next one is date command. Of course this is straightforward, it is going to give the current date and time. Let's see this in action. So if you give date, it is showing today, and what day it is, what month it is, what date today is, and time in UTC, and the year. Date is one of the very few commands which support something called format specifiers, and format specifiers are given using plus. Suppose if I give percentage small d, it is only showing the month. Now if I give plus percentage m, it is showing the month in number. Percentage d is giving me the date, and percentage m is giving me the month number, July, which is 7th month. And if I give date plus percentage capital H, it is giving me the hours, which is 21. Now if you want to print only the date without any time, you can give the format specifier percentage t, which gives 20th, 7th month and 2018. We can also specify multiple format specifiers. So whenever we give multiple format specifiers, we have to specify them in double quotes, percentage h for hours, percentage m for minutes, percentage s for seconds. So this is something about date command. Let's come back. And next command is cal, which is supposed to show you current year, current month, calendar. So let's say this cal. So current year is 2018, current month is July. If you want to see the entire year's calendar, you have to give the argument which year calendar you want to see. So you can see the cal of whole year's calendar. And if you want to look at the calendar of particular month, so let's say I want to see the calendar of August in the year 1986, I got the calendar. So that is about calendar or cal command. And next command is passwd. So this command is used to change user's current password. So I am not going to completely use this, but I will show you some part of it. So whenever you give passwd and press enter, it is asking me for my old password. I am not giving it, so it is saying sorry. If I give my old password, it will ask for new password two times, and then that new password will become your current password. So that is how passwd works. And next one is lock. So this is used to lock the terminal for some time. So let's see that lock. So it is asking me for a password. I am giving A, B, C, D. It is asking again the same key, A, B, C, D. So now the this terminal or this screen is locked. So if anyone else other than me comes here and tries to use ask for key. So only I know the key, which is ABCD. So now I am again using the Unix operating system. So that is about lock command. And next command is cat. So this command is used to create files, and also after creating the files, we can view the content in the files. For example, this is how you use cat command to create files: cat greater than abc dot txt. So the meaning of this is whatever type below this command will be stored in abc dot txt. Here greater than is called output redirection operator. So welcome to Unix. This is cool. To come out of this editing mode, we have to press Ctrl D key. Ctrl D. So what happened here is these two lines are being stored in the file abc.txt. If you want to verify it, the second use of cat command is to view the content in the file. Cat space abc.txt. So you can see these two lines are stored in abc.txt. This is how you use cat command.